As a photographer, traveling is kind of a bonus advantage you get. But being an architectural photographer is even more exciting for me. At one point, I'm in this huge mansion, 5 to 10 acres of land for just a single residence. From there, even bigger master plan projects, roughly 150 to 200 acres, and then a small tiny house made for the displaced people who are victims of river erosion. So, in a way, I'm on a permanent vacation living in different types of architecture while photographing them. Before going for a new assignment, I usually try to sit with the architects and they generously share their ideas and thoughts behind all the decisions they have taken to make it big. And then they ask for my visions, my perspective to their creations, their buildings, the new spaces they have designed. So instead of having one office, my workspace moves every day from one building to another, from one space to another. Sometimes it's a luxurious residence. Sometimes it's a hospital, a museum, or a school. Then sometimes it's an office or tiny apartment, headquarters of a big corporate house or a governmental office building. The list goes on. So what's the story? Well, it didn't come here with a planned path, of course. That's not how life works, and I have still no specific plan for the future too. It's always about how you feel. It all began with a small question anyone can ask. What are those issues you love and hate most? I love traveling, but I don't want to just touch and run the places as traditional tourists do. I wanted to feel and breathe in new places, experience that gentle breezes blows there. Talk to the people who live there, walk on their streets as they do. And what do I hate most? Living in a confined space, repeating myself every day like a snail or something, and make myself believe that only this space or this office is the only real thing on this planet and nothing else matters except for my bosses. So that's simple. Then why wait? I clearly know what I want. Let's do this. How? Here's the crazy part. This is the element in the room that we all know, yet just try to live with it. But man, how will you earn? Who will pay for your tickets? Don't be stupid enough. Stand in the queue and get a job. And there's a little daydream start mocking you. You don't do things because you want to earn money or buy a luxurious ship. You do things because you love them. You live with them. Things make you feel comfortable, makes you feel alive. And I haven't started talking anything about photography yet. God, it's not just about photography. It's about not giving up. It's about keeping your little ideas alive against the myth we create, making ourselves believe to live our entire life with this loop. As for my case, it's photography primarily, but also about meeting people and experiencing new spaces, understanding new lights and colors, or creating other stuff through whatever media I love. It's not just one thing. Why I would just one thing. It's a beautiful life and I want to experience every bit of my parts. But is it something easy to do? There is no proven path here to follow my dream. Yes, there is not. And those default modes aren't applicable while you are trying to deal with dreams. I tell you how it works. It works just by believing it. Just by not accepting the default modes. If you have enough courage to stand for your own crazy paths, then the rest will follow you anyway. For me, when I was in architecture school, I, along with my friends, tried to start an architectural magazine having a little knowledge about graphics and photography with no money at all. And we spent almost 2 years, knocked all the possible doors we could reach and failed, of course. But that little initiative got us introduced to one of the most successful architects of our country, Mr. Mustafa Kalipawa. And we ended up making a new architectural magazine called Dot, having him as the editor and us the assistant editors. That whole process got me a lot. Also, from there, I started to understand the importance of architecture photography. I got interested and thought, why not? If one genre in photography I would be particularly interested, that would be architectural photography. And I started following that trail, not knowing anything about anything at all. Before then, I do love to take photographs, but there are no perspective. But after this, it felt good. And then I left out that magazine to pursue architecture photography full time. After quitting almost 1 year, I got nothing. So I had two options. One is feeling regretted and trying to go back to or stay stupid. I remained stupid. I started digging other stuff too that I love. As I said, it's not necessary that you just do one work. You can do whatever you love to do. Try new things, new ways to explore, experiment, experience life. For me, I started exploring animation, cinematography, whatever I felt good or curious about. Then, what happened? Did anyone commission you? Yes, luckily one of my colleagues from my previous office commissioned me for a residential project for which I got a little payment. For the rent stuff I read, because I did not have any proper gears too. Then little by little, people started to notice my work, but still nothing significant. Then I got a beautiful project by Kashyap Bhagwat, the Friendship Hospital, Satkhira, one of the most memorable journey in my career so far. He's one of the most recognizable architects working in the world right now. And also, this architect himself is an amazing photographer. This work got published in so many local and international publications, and that project won the Riva Award 2021. This hospital is situated in the rural area of Bangladesh and also nearer to Sundarbans. In the same year, I also got the privilege to work another architect whose work is admired and studied all over the world, architect Marina Tavassum. These two are some of the most recognizable architects in the world right now. So working with them taught me a lot about architecture and photography. And their belief is in my work gave me the necessary fuel to continue my passion. Following this, as my dreams was to travel the world, I started taking more leaps. I participated in the Sharjah Architecture Triennial 2019 as a team member of my architect Marina Tavassum. I also have documented architectural projects in the India and United Arab Emirates. Every story is unique, but some are just unforgettable. One of them is my recent trip to the Chor Hizla in the middle of River Meghna. Meghna is one of the largest rivers in Bangladesh among the three main rivers. And this tiny chor is in the middle of the river. A unique experiment by Marina Tavassum Architects from the continuity of Sharjah's study. She has designed a house for the river erosion victims so that they could leave the house while river erosion starts. I went there and lived with the people and along with the architect team. The story itself might take a whole TED talk, but knowing the people from their own living place is always something that can never feel until you live with them. We took a small tent and lived just by the river Meghna to bath on the full moon on the river. In a way, we lived just like them, and also I photographed and made a documentary on the whole process. From making the entire house, training the local people how to build these new mobile houses, soon they started to adopt them. It was a wonderful collaboration between the architect and the indigenous community. A real-world problem solving with the power of architecture. Another similar project I have documented recently is in Ukhiya Cox's Bazar, near to the largest refugee camp in the world right now, which is famously known as Rohingya camp, which is one of our biggest crises right now. My journey kept going until the COVID happened. Everything we knew changed. Everything just stopped. But that's what life is. Our plans are never to be fulfilled. I started exploring other things I love. One of them is animation. I made a 3D animated short film called Reimagined, the National Parliament House of Bangladesh. It was a tribute to master architect Louis Kahn. The National Parliament House of Bangladesh is by far one of the most recognizable architectural works in modern architecture. The idea was to give a walkthrough inside this architectural marvel. And also, what if Louis Kahn himself gives us a walkthrough? First, I tried to find out if there is any detailed 3D model that I can use. That might reduce the work time, but there is not one detail. So I had to model the building from scratch, and there is no plan also. I have studied thousands of images from all possible sources and started modeling from those references. It was a fun and challenging one to the. But when I finally got the end result, it was rewarding. Although inside the 3D workspace I planned and framed, it was an architectural photographer within the software. As I did it during the pandemic, the idea was, what if we all die and there is only the architecture and nature that all remains? It was an ambition, one definitely, and only 20 to 25% that I could make into reality. And within the time and restrictions I had. Things are getting normal globally. So far, I have documented 130 projects, but nothing changed for me. It's still a new space, still a new mystery waiting for me to be solved. It's a crazy profession. You work your ass off and then earn money and then spend all of them to buy higher and higher tools to fulfill your even more crazier obsessions. So why do you still do it? Surely not to earn money, right? No. If it was just for money, then I would rather have been in onion business yet. It's far easier and more profitable. Why do photography then? Because you want it to remain stupid. Deep inside your heart, it has a different chamber that doesn't fill with normal day-to-day fuel. It needs a different kind of fuel that you cannot buy with onion business or any other more rational or straight profitable businesses. It's that crazy hole inside your heart that keeps pushing you to become stupid, doing the most incompatible decision possible even on your darkest days. How many of you know that all those crazy souls spend every bit of their life doing irrational, non-profitable, in the social sense, utterly stupid works just to fill up their defective hearts? You may call them the human with defected hearts or animal with defected hearts. And maybe I am just one of them.